Repair. It is the first of our themes this year in our Lenten journey, and it is the theme that we embrace and encounter in our first service of Lent, our service of Ash Wednesday. And I invite you, friends, to join us on Ash Wednesday at either noon or 7 p.m. to receive the invitation into a holy Lent, to receive the ashes upon your forehead, and to be reminded anew of the journey that we take as Christians in our life to constantly work and strive towards a more full and more holistic embrace of God's work in this world and God's work on us as individuals in this world. When we begin our Christian lives, either as infants or many of us, maybe even as adults, we begin here at the font with the waters of new life, the waters of renewal, the waters of spiritual regeneration. And at the moment of that baptism, as we prepare to enter into that experience, we profess the baptismal covenant and we commit ourselves anew to it. And in that baptismal covenant, we hear the question, will you persevere in resisting evil? And whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord. And our response in each and every time that we are invited to answer that question, we respond, I will with God's help. I will with God's help. That is the key emphasis in this journey into Lent, in this departure on the way as we follow Christ in these 40 days of fasting and penitence, as we once more return to the work of repair and reconciliation that we undertake in our lives. And this is not new. This is not a fresh concept. It lies at the very heart of the experience of Ash Wednesday. As we will hear in those services at noon and 7 p.m., this goes back to the very beginning of the church's observance of Lent. As the prayer book also says, in this season of Lent, we are provided a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. But it was also a time when those who, because of notorious sins, had been separated from the body of the faithful were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness and restored to the fellowship of the church. Thereby, the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution set forth in the gospel of our Savior, and of the need which all Christians continually have to renew their repentance and faith. That all Christians continually have to renew their faith. That is the work of repair that we are invited into as we embrace Ash Wednesday. As we receive the ashes upon our forehead, as we are reminded again of our own mortality, and ultimately of our reliance on God to give us life, to give us health, and to invite us ever more fully into the light of His work in this world. So I hope, friends, that you will join me, you will join all of us here at St. Anne's in beginning that work of repair. In beginning that work of restoration, in beginning that work of reconciliation, in beginning that journey over these 40 days as we prepare anew to live more fully into the light and life of God. So, once more, friends, I invite you to join us at noon or 7 p.m. on Wednesday and live anew into this commitment to Christ. And in this commitment to His work and love in this world. Blessings, friends, today and always.